MED23 gene defect. It's very rare. We are the first case in Pennsylvania, second case known worldwide, and since our diagnosis, there's a case in Canada as well. Tyler was born first, and he had the condition, and then we had Noah, who is 2 years behind Tyler in age, and he was perfectly fine. Following that, we were pregnant with twins, and they were fraternal twins. So one of the twins has the condition, and one does not. They have severe intellectual disability, and their neuromotor system is affected. So they are handicapped in all ways. They do not speak, talk, use their hands purposely. Basically, they're severely disabled in all ways. They function at a very immature level. Functionally, Tyler is 13 and he functions around a 1.5 to 2-year-old. We do everything for them. It starts by getting them out of bed pretty early, generally, and waking them up, toileting them. Once we toilet them, they go into their mobility chairs, and then we feed them their complete feeds, so we do that for them. Brush their teeth, do their hair, get them dressed. They wear AFOs, which are orthotics on the legs, so they have to have those on to do anything that requires any mobility or standing. They do attend a special needs school presently, so they go to school Monday through Friday. Anything you do has to be altered or changed, and you can't just have a regular vehicle. You have to have a wheelchair van, and you have to have the ramps into the home, and the cost associated with all those things adds up quickly. Tyler, who's the oldest, for a lot of years saw many, many doctors, and nobody was really interested in what was going on with him because they thought it was very difficult to diagnose. We went to several doctors over the Pittsburgh area, and then were referred out to several other hospitals in different states, and we traveled and saw some of the best doctors in the country, and that was not successful. So eventually we ended up at the Undiagnosed Disease Program here at the NIH, and through the Undiagnosed Disease Program, they diagnosed our children. When they were searching for a diagnosis for the boys, they sent their cells to several pharmaceutical companies across the country. And this Edison Pharmaceutical that is over in California eventually started testing their cells with some of the medications that are out. And Luke's cells responded to the medication in a positive way. Through that information, the National Institutes of Health contacted us and invited us to a drug trial for the medication to see if he would respond. Nothing's overnight. You're just constantly searching for the next door that you can open, and they're all closed, and you don't know which one to pick, but you sometimes find the right one.